Good morning, children. Today we will do the revision of the chapter Rise and Spread of Islam. We will discuss all the questions given in the back exercise. Then let's start. The first question is, what was the Kaaba? The answer will be, in Mecca, there was an ancient square shrine called Kaaba. It housed the idols of 360 gods and goddesses. It served as a holy place of annual pilgrimage for the Arabic tribes. Second question is, when and how was God's message revealed to Prophet Muhammad? See the answer. Muhammad turned to spiritualism and started going to the hills around Mecca for meditation. During one such meditation in Cave Hira in 610 AD, he had a vision of Angel Gabriel giving him the message, that is, revelation of God. Third question is, why did Muhammad and his followers flee to Medina? Muhammad and his followers flee to Medina because of the following reasons. The leading citizens of Mecca opposed Muhammad's idea of one God. The second reason is, the wealthy Arab merchants also feared huge losses due to reduced number of pilgrims visiting Kaaba after the removal of idol from there. Now question number 4. Which dynasty's rule is called the Islamic Golden Age and why? Answer will be, the Abbasid's reign is termed as the Islamic Golden Age because during the reign of Abbasids, Muslims contributed to the development of science, mathematics, literature, art, medicine and other disciplines. For further reference, you will go through page number 18. We have already discussed about these answers in the modules soul. Now number 5, write a note on the 5 pillars of Islam. Muhammad preached the observance of the 5 principles or pillars of Islam by Muslims. These are listed below. Number 1, Shahada. There is only one God or Allah and Muhammad is the prophet of Allah. Second is Salat, which means every Muslim must offer prayers, that is namaz, 5 times a day. Then some Muslims must observe fast from dawn to dusk in the holy month of Ramzan. Then zakat, Muslim must give certain portion of their wealth as alms to help the poor. And the last one is Hajj. Muslim must go on the pilgrimage or Hajj to Kaaba in Mecca at least once in their lifetime. Children, you have to copy down these answers in the same manner in your notebook neatly. And after writing each answer, you will draw the finishing. Number 6. How did the Turkish slaves harm the Abbasid Caliphate? In the following ways, Turkish slaves harmed the Abbasid Caliphate. The number of Turkish slaves grew in the Abbasid administration because many provinces of the empire were administered by them. As a result, they became powerful and independent. The provincial Turkish slave governors became powerful and independent. Third, they turned the provinces into their kingdoms, thus reducing the power of the Abbasid Caliphate. For the further reference, you will go through page number 19. Children, you have to answer in the same manner during exam also, in points. Okay? Have a nice day. Thank you.